I'm sitting here tonight in the studio, softly lighted, and have a cup of hot tea, a couple of cookies. Sort of a relaxed atmosphere here tonight. Hi, I'm Bill Pearce, and I welcome you to this circle of love called Nightsounds. And again, if you've been with us before, you know pretty well what the format's going to be. Relaxation. Can you relax? Or do you allow the things, the stimuli of the day to keep perking in your brain? Tonight's program is entitled Release. Freedom from bondage. Do you sense that you're under bondage to anyone, anything, a system? Whatever it might be. Well, tonight's program is going to center around the subject of release. Release from bondage. I sense a certain amount of that in my life right now, but there's only one force that can set us free. And I'm going to begin tonight with a scripture verse, which is a wonderful way to begin and continue and conclude. This is a very important verse. Psalm 119:45 reads, I will walk at liberty and at ease, for I have sought and inquired for and desperately required your precepts. So, in essence, what he's saying is, I'm going to move on in the name of Jesus. On Jesus tonight, today, tomorrow, every day. Our program tonight with the title Release. I used to do a morning format in radio. That's the kind of music I always enjoyed starting with. And I sort of slipped it in tonight in more of a laid-back kind of expression in Night Sounds. So we'll back off a little bit from that kind of energy. Nonetheless, we want to keep the intensity going because Jesus is, and He lives tonight. And our program, Release, is about freedom from bondage. Mentioned a few moments ago that many of us, sometime or another, have found ourselves under bondage to something. To a person, to a thing, to an idea, to a system, maybe to a job. Another scripture verse, and this is the bulwark, the keystone of our programming. John, the Gospel, chapter 8, verse 36. And it reads, "So, if the Son liberates you, makes you free, then you are really and unquestionably free." So I guess the question tonight is, are you really and unquestionably free? Because if we allow ourselves to be controlled by other people, thoughts, feelings, habits, we're really not free. And I don't believe this is where God wants you to be. In Christ, we have been made free as we trust in Him. Motivational speaker Joyce Meyer said, "At one time, I had a terrible problem with guilt and condemnation. And there's nothing worse than feeling bad about yourself or being so legalistic that you can never enjoy anything without feeling guilty." And she said, "It took time, but God has set me free. I know in my spirit, however, that many people will struggle with these issues. They're being controlled not only by guilt, but by other people and by their own appetites, habit patterns, emotions. So tonight's program is about freedom. Freedom from guilt, freedom from fear, freedom from bondage." I suppose I'm the last one to do a program like this, because through the years, in my desire to please people, to serve God, to stay out of the way, I've lost a certain amount of assertiveness. Not that we should be obnoxious. We need to be positive. 1 Peter 2, verse 16 encourages, "Live as free people, without employing your freedom as a pretext for wickedness." In other words, we're to live in freedom without using our liberty as an excuse to sin. Freedom is a wonderful gift. When the Berlin Wall finally was smashed, it was done so with passion. One Christian leader said, "The more willing I am to be led by the Holy Spirit, the more freedom He gives me to make my own decisions." We can even be passively adaptive to other people, to the point where we then are under bondage. Others may come with their neuroses and lay them on us. We absorb them, they go away, having ventilated, and they're more free than we are. Maybe we're the ones that should have been the help to them. We will walk in freedom once we make the decision to begin to believe what the Word of God says and stop believing our feelings and the unanswered part of our minds that's bogged down. Let's believe tonight that we can hear from God, that He has a glorious future planned for us, and believe that no devil in hell can keep you or me out of God's will. Philippians 1:6 is a favorite verse of mine, especially when I begin to lose momentum, spiritually or emotionally, or even physically. You recall that verse? "He who has begun a good work in you will perform it until the day of Jesus Christ." So when we stumble and hit the potholes and the brick walls, we can know that God is there. He's picking us up and He's saying, "Let's go. Forget the potholes, forget the detours, forget the defeats, forget the guilt, the failure. You are mine. Let's go together." Joyce Meyer, whom we're quoting to some degree tonight, said, "I had many problems with legalism in my life. I was in bondage. Much of it was self-imposed. For example, I cleaned my house from top to bottom every single day. I vacuumed, dusted, polished the mirrors. I was busy working. Then I was judgmental toward my friends who didn't work as hard as I did. I felt sorry for myself because I had so much to do and couldn't get it done. I couldn't go when they invited me out to lunch or to go shopping. I needed to be free to say, yes, I'd like to go. I need to get out of the house. But I just couldn't do that unless all my work was done. In a sense, I was out of balance. So there are various degrees of bondage. And if you sense that you are in this category, we're centering on Jesus Christ. If the Son shall set you free, you shall be free indeed. Exclamation point. And as I've mentioned before, I find myself under bondage to my own systems, to other people, because in the attempt to please and to do and be the right thing, sometimes we fall into an overload, an overreaction, and we can find ourselves in bondage. The fulfillment of our dreams, visions, and goals requires self-control. God puts something in our hearts. But for it to come to pass, we must walk the road of obedience to His Word and to His will as we know it. Obedience means we're not always going to get our way. So in a sense, we have to construct some boundaries. We're going to have to learn to say no to others, to ourselves. Self-control is freedom. The need to be ready to discipline ourselves, to operate in new levels of self-control. And as one said, God wants you to come up higher. Our music tonight is going to reflect motivation, incentive, impetus. These are good words. They need not bind us, but they can set us free to move on. Night Sounds is a distinctive kind of an expression, if for no other reason than the music we use. I was just reading a survey that we sent out to our listeners, and one of the questions was, do you enjoy the music you hear in Night Sounds? What changes would you make? Well, the young people said it needs to be more upbeat, we are outdated. And then we come to the middle person who says, I like it all. I like the old and the new, so play what God leads you to play. And then we get the other end of the spectrum saying, I want the old numbers back. The old songs, they have the power. Don't appreciate the contemporary. Well, we have a mix of listeners, and we do try to serve everyone's desires, if we can, without compromise. We can't please everyone, of course. Abe Lincoln couldn't. If he couldn't, I sure can't. So we're going to turn to one of the old ones tonight. Not an old hymn of Wesley or others who were way back there. As wonderful as they are, this was a little later song. Sort of an easygoing number and mood. The Melody Four Quartet, with whom I worked for almost 40 years on the road and in recordings, put down a number that I think was written by John Peterson. It's entitled, I Believe in Miracles. And I'm convinced tonight that God is where you are right now, and He wants you to believe Him and to be free of those things that would impede your progress. Many of you will remember this one. I believe in miracles, for I've seen a soul set free from bondage, from sin and death. Let's listen.
I believe in miracles. I've seen a soul set free. Miraculous the change. I believe in miracles.
Four Quartet, I believe in miracles. Why? Because I believe in God, and He is the one who sets us free. Free indeed. That beautiful verse from 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 16, reads again, "Live as free people, yet without employing your freedom as a pretext for wickedness." Living in the freedom of God without using our liberty as an excuse for anything. Freedom is really fantastic, but at the same time, it's a tremendous responsibility. It doesn't mean that we can do anything we want to do, but the more willing we are to be led by the Spirit of God, the more freedom He gives us to make our own decisions. Tonight's program entitled Release. I would say just about every one of us needs to be released from something that's binding our souls and spirits, our personalities, our potential. It may be a person, it may be a system, it may be the most innocent-looking thing which can hold us in its spell. How about habits? There are so many habits that we get into. Some of them are so subtle we don't know that we're being confined. And suddenly we wake up to see that, hey, this thing has me. I don't control it. It controls me, and certainly emotions are like that. When some kind of a stimulus comes our way that we recognize as negative, we actually have the power to say, I will control this. I am a free person in Jesus Christ. I refuse to be under bondage. I must work this in my own life. So in a sense tonight, I'm just sharing with you what has worked for many people, myself included, and any of you who are in bondage. It may take a while to get out of it, but Jesus Christ can set you free. Let's read it again. The Gospel of John, chapter 8, verse 36. Quote, "So, if the Son, Jesus Christ, liberates you, makes you free people, then you are really and unquestionably free." Self-control is freedom. Fear torments, and dread is fear's very close relative. It steals our joy and peace. That's why the psalmist exclaimed, "Restore unto me the joy of your salvation." spiritual motivational speaker Joyce Meyer said, "I urge you to confront this factor and refuse to be tormented. Dread and fear are conquered through confrontation, not by running from it." Jesus died an atoning sacrifice on the cross of Calvary to set us free from bondage. Someone said we must become more comfortable with confrontation. This is difficult for me. I want peace. I want things to work right. And yet living in a world of sin and with flawed people, ourselves included, it's a tough assignment. Confrontation prevents the spread of strife. Confront rumors, complaints, judgments, murmuring, gossip, lies, misunderstanding, anything that could usher strife and dissonance into our lives. We want to be free people. Wouldn't you like to be free? Free from bondage? It can happen. So like the psalmist, let's make a decision to walk in the glorious freedom God has provided for us, to be free indeed. Amen to that. I'd like to close our program tonight with a song that speaks of usefulness, to be used in the program and work of God. We'll cause a certain amount of dissonance as far as people may be concerned, certainly as far as the enemy of our souls, who is going to try to impede our progress any way he can. So let's just shore up our defenses and polish our armor and say, I'm going to move ahead, and I'm going to advance in the name and through the power of Jesus Christ. I'd like to call on Val Halloran, a new voice to Nightsounds, as we join her in this prayer. Lord, use me, set me free, make me a soldier of the cross right now. Use me, Lord, as you will.
Use me, please use me, Lord. I want to do the things you want me to. Use me, please use me, Lord, 'cause all I have to give, I give to you. Even if I never write a song the whole world hears, or have a name that anyone remembers, it only matters that I live a life to please the Lord, 'cause he's the only one I'll have to answer. Use me, please use me, Lord.
Things you
'cause all I have to give, I give to you. Because all I have to give, I give to you.
Use me, Lord. All I have to give, I give to you. Heavenly Father, help us to trust you to take us from bondage to freedom and release. Help us to believe and to know the joy of our salvation restored. I trust that you will just touch that one who's bound right now, he or she asking for release. Touch us all, Lord, with the spirit and freedom of Jesus Christ, in whose name we pray. Amen. Thank you so much tonight for sharing with us. It's great to be with you. Let's pray for each other, upholding one another before the Lord. Our mailing address is Nightsounds, Wheaton, Illinois, 60189. So I trust we'll be brought together again by His Spirit to enjoy His power and release. Till we meet again, God bless you and make you free, and a peaceful good night to all of you.